GROQ just got an upgrade. It enables us to significantly reduce the amount of repeated code we have in our queries using custom functions. I'm really excited for this one because I'll often have two queries that are almost identical, and I'll update one, I'll forget to update the other, and this leads to broken or inconsistent experiences on the front end. Let's solve this in three steps. First, we're going to look at a problematic query. Then we're going to write a function going over the syntax and replace the entire projection of that query. And then we're going to write another function that's just going to replace part of that projection. Diving in, I have this sample web page. We have latest articles, we have featured article, and we have related articles. These are generated using three different queries, which we can see here. All three of these queries have the exact same projections, different filters though. So if I were to update one of these and I forget to update the others, now I've got an author here, but my other cards don't have the author, leading to an inconsistent experience. So we know we shouldn't be repeating ourselves. Now, how do we fix that? Let's replace the entire projection with a new function. Let's define a custom GROQ function. It's going to go at the top of our query and within define query. We're going to type fn. We're going to give it a custom namespace. I'm going to call this articles and then two colons. This is standard GROQ function syntax. And then the name of our function, let's call it article preview. And it can take a parameter. So we're going to pass it the entire article object. And now we're going to return a projection, which is going to be the article. And then I'm just going to copy our existing projection, paste it here, and always end in a semicolon. So that's how we define a custom function. Now let's use it by replacing our existing projection here. And I want to spread out the results of this call here. And then I'm going to do articles, double colon, and then article preview. And then let's pass it the result of this. We can use at, which kind of represents this, meaning it will pass the results of this filter. And let's replace the other projections here. Save it. And now we can see that we have the author on each of these different queries. Perfect. Well, we've defined our first custom GROQ function and we've saved a lot of repeated code. Now let's create a new function for partial projections. So let's say I only want to add a new reading time, an estimated reading time to the article grids, but not the featured article. Well, I'm going to create a new function, always starting with fn. I'm going to use the same namespace and we'll call this reading time. And we're going to pass it that same article object. And this time, I am going to return a new property called estimated reading time. And this is notable because this is some logic right here that's a bit more complex. It's not just pulling in the fields, but it has some logic. And of course, I only want to define this once. So I'm going to do that and then go down here. And then I'm going to spread this one out too and say articles reading time and pass it the same object. And just note, I'm using the spread here. We could easily just do it like this too and say reading time, but my front end's already looking for estimated reading time, so I don't want to have to drill down. So that's why I'm just spreading it out. And I only want this on the first and last one. Oh, and I made a mistake up here. Always end with a semicolon. And now we'll save this, switch over to our website. And now we see this reading time on the first set of cards, not the featured article, and this last set of cards. And of course, these would be scattered throughout the site, but they're just pulled into one page for demo purposes. And that is how we define a second function to replace just part of the projection. Anytime we find ourselves repeating code, we want to think, how can we abstract this into a function so we can only update it in one spot and it'll syndicate everywhere that references that function? Well, thanks for watching this tutorial and demo on GROQ custom functions, and I'll see you in the next one.